The ORTF, the French Broadcasting System, presents Masterworks of French Music, a program compiled and written by Anne Ray, being an examination of the role of nature in French music. To begin today's program, here is Claude Debussy's La mer est plus belle, the sea is more beautiful.
La mer est plus belle que les cathédrales. Nourrice fidèle, berceuse de râle, la mer.
That song of Debussy's, with words by Verlaine, presents the sea as a mysterious goddess, both comforting and terrifying. The sea has inspired at least two generations of French musicians and composers of this century and the latter part of the 19th. For Fauré and Dupart, as well as Ravel and Debussy, the sea was a tableau vivant that called for a musical description. The subtle, changing color of the sea, its remarkable mass, its capacity for both immobility and simultaneous movement, make it a symbolic equivalent for the music composed in France between the turn of the century and the decade of the 20s. Fluid harmonies, free forms, flexibility of technique. The listener thinks immediately of such Debussy works as De l'aube à midi, Sur la mer, or Sirène, respectively From Dawn to Noon on the Sea, and Sirens. Les Poissons d'Or, The Golden Fish, is a less banal example of Debussy's art, a remarkable piano work in which the instrument weaves a maritime tapestry. The performer here is Arturo Michelangeli.
Thank you.
color, reflections, light and indistinct forms all blend together in that remarkable Debussy composition we just heard. In Maurice Ravel's piano works, we also find such maritime titles as Ondine and Jeux d'eau, water sprite and water games. In Bach's L'Océan, A Boat on the Ocean, is perhaps less well known than the previous two, but even more interesting as far as we are concerned. The work was dedicated by Ravel to the painter Paul Assol, and unlike Debussy's vague, dreamlike evocations of the sea, Ravel is much more precise in his description. The work has a swaying, rhythmic quality which evokes a small boat being tossed regularly by the waves. In Bach's Sur l'Océan is performed here by Jacques Février.
Thank you.
The excerpts we have heard up to now have described the sea as an idealized maternal presence. Henri Dupin's approach is much more realistic, dramatic, reflecting the storm and strength of the sea, while on the symbolic side, it speaks of human failures and moral torment. As an illustration, let's listen to La Vague et la Cloche, The Wave and the Bell, sung by Bernard Crusen. The words, by the way, are by the French poet François Coppée.
Parmi les vagues, une bride d'amour. Je voguais sans fanale dans la nuit, morne rameur, n'ayant plus l'espoir du rivage. Ses balles sur le front et le vent me glaçait leurs rêves jusqu'aux entrailles. Les vagues s'écroulaient ainsi que les murailles avec ce rythme lent qu'un silence.
Some of us may not find Duppal's expressionist approach very appealing. It is somewhat insistent, even turgid. We can then turn to something a little more refined. Gabriel Fauré's Barcarolle, for example. Here the sea is no longer a thematic subject, but rather the object of a musical form. Fauré's 6-8 rhythm links the flowing of time with that of water, taking us drifting on calm lakes and lagoons. The fifth barcarolle, however, there are 13, takes us out on the high seas. Its brilliant musical coloration, rhythmic variety, and enchanting melody make the fifth barcarolle a masterpiece. Our performance here is by Jean-Philippe Collard. Thank you. With Gabriel Fauré's Barcarolle, we conclude today's program on the sea and its influence on French composers. You've been listening to Masterworks of French Music, a program produced and recorded in Paris by the ORTF, the French Broadcasting System.